The tragic deaths of 19 firefighters has researchers looking at new ways to protect those on the fire lines.
CBS North Carolina's Megan Newland headed over to NC State to see what's next in wildfire shelters.
Human lives. It's really about saving lives.
These are the faces that inspire NC State researchers as they work to create a better fire shelter. 19 wildland firefighters died in 2013 after becoming trapped by flames in Arizona. Some of those who died had deployed fire shelters.
A fire shelter is kind of a last line of defense for a wildland firefighter.
When there's no way to escape an oncoming fire, firefighters can place the shelter over their bodies to offer them some protection as the fire burns over them.
That's why the focus of our research has been on developing materials that are more heat resistant, and they have to be resistant to very intense flames. This is what we call the fire domes.
Shelters are tested inside this fire chamber on NC State's campus. Researchers say it's the only one of its kind.
You're talking about 2,000 degrees Celsius. So it gives you a good environment that's going to simulate what the firefighter is going to see in real life.
Researchers are looking for just the right combination and arrangement of materials to protect firefighters from a wildfire's intense flames, heat, and wind.
The structure of that fabric is very complicated. It's many layers made up of heat-resistant fibers, but also other things that go into it that gives it that heat-blocking ability. It would be able to insulate. It would be able to maintain the air temperature within the shelter as low as possible for as long as possible.
Yeah. They also have to make the shelters light enough so that firefighters can carry them at all times. Although fire shelters will always be a last resort, researchers say their goal is to give firefighters in a desperate situation every possible chance to survive. For What's Next, Maggie Newland, CBS North Carolina.